morning to Miss Rohani and all our fellow classmates. And I'm Chen Xinyi, this is Chong Yingling, Maha and Chai Yingxing. We will be presenting about Time Warner. So firstly, I will be starting with the history of Time Warner. Time Inc. is began in 1932. It's a publishing company for Time magazine. After their debut in 1933, it set standards for National News magazine. And then came Warner Bros. In the early 20th century. It emerged in commercial film industry in the US. And it is the Hollywood's big five in the year of 1933. In the year of 1987, through the film The Jazz Singer, it introduced the sound technology and it became a huge hit. In 1930, Warner Bros. Ventured into music publishing and radio broadcasting and producing gangster musical and Serge Buckley films. In 1939, they launched the Fortune magazine and in 1936 made a lot of profit through Time News magazine. In the year 1960, Time Inc. and Warner Bros. Developed conglomerate corporate structures in the media and cultural industries, and then it became Time Warner. Then they faced challenges and huge debts, but now they are the world's largest media corporations, and they are expansion in cultural and communication industries, and now they are secure in the 21st century following of the formation of AO Time Warner. And last decade, we stepped back from conglomerate that was similar to its growth and divested in many operations. I pass to Chong Yingling to present the next time.
So I've been talking about the corporate structure. So Time Warner is the one of the largest group in the 900 subscriber and to the three segment, which is the HBO, Turner Broadcasting System, and also the Warner Bros. So I'll be talking about the Turner Broadcasting System. So it operates the entertainment cable networks, which includes the TNT, Cartoon Network, CNN, and also the HLN, and also TBS. So Turner Broadcasting System is distribute the its global entertainment and also the news brands in over the 60 countries. And they also divide into the three subsidiary. It's Turner Europe transmit into the 70 branded channels with will fit in 27 languages to over 100 European, Middle Eastern, and also the African territories. And also Turner Asia Pacific runs 46 channels in 13 languages in 38 countries. And also Turner Broadcasting System in Asia Pacific distribute and also sell advertisement for HBO and also Warner Bros. In India. Turner is the first of the providing multi-channel television in all of the Latin America. So I'll talk about the HBO, which is the home box office. It operates the premium cable and also the satellite television network, HBO and also the Cinemax. It's dependent on features film, documentary, and also the sport. So HBO also compete with the Netflix as a primary long-term competitor in developing the over-the-top film streaming service. So in 2014, HBO international subscriber base reached 92 million. And however, HBO still having the largest group of subscription than the Netflix. So the third segment will be the Warner Bros. Warner Bros. Produce and distribute the motion picture, television programming, video games, and also the live stage plays. It also license right the intellectual property license. And also Warner Bros. Divide into three divisions, which is the motion picture, which includes the Warner Bros. And also the New Line Cinema. Warner Bros. Television Groups, which includes the Warner Bros. Television Group, and also are another five of the United States television production outfit, and also the home entertainment. The segment also consists of the DC comic, which continue produce the comic character such as the Batman and also the Superman and so forth. And in 2008, the motion picture division significantly streamlined its structure by closing its specifically film units, Warner Independent Picture and also the Picture House, and merging its independent unit, Line New Cinema, with Warner Bros. So they are the board of the director of Time Warner. This one, Jeffrey, is a chairman and also the CEO of Time Warner. And the Richard is chairman and CEO of the HBO. The third person will be John. He is the chairman and CEO of the Turner Broadcasting System. And the last one is Kevin, the chairman and also the CEO of Warner Bros. So I will pass to Mahal.
I'll be talking about the mergers and acquisitions that has occurred since the company began. There are several mergers and acquisitions that has made Time Warner the company that is today. I'm going to list down a few. In 1993, they purchased all stake of the Six Flags theme parks and later sold for a profit of $1.86 billion. And on October 10, 1996, they bought Turner Entertainment Broadcasting Company for $7.5 billion. In 2001, they bought AOL, internet provider Time Warner, for $164 billion. And in July 2006, they acquired Expedia Communication for $531.5 million. And in August 2010, they acquired Shed Media for £100 million. And in May 2011, they acquired Flixster and also the Rotten Tomatoes website that comes with it. And in June 2012, Time Warner acquired Alloy Entertainment. And on August 6, 2012, Time Warner acquired Bleachers Report, which is a sports website, for $175 million. And in 2007, they also bought a 10% stake in Hulu for $583 million. Now I'll focus more on the major mergers and acquisitions from Time Warner. The biggest one so far has been the merger with Turner Broadcasting, which actually became an entire subsidiary of the Time Warner company. Time Warner merged with Turner Broadcasting for $7.5 billion. And they actually previously owned 12% of their stakes just by buying stakes from like little bit. And then they bought the entire remaining 82% in 1996, and thus they owning the Turner Broadcasting System. And by this, they actually got the access to, Turner actually had a whole film library of before 1950 movies. And so by merging with them, Time Warner actually have access to pre-1950 and post-1950 film libraries, which makes it the biggest film library in the world. Next. AOL and Time Warner merger. This has been the biggest loss for Time Warner to date. They had a loss of $99 billion after they bought this America Online company. And the reason for this loss is because as soon as they bought this high-speed internet provider, there were a lot of competitors that rose quickly and they were serving better. And that's why they had the loss. And Time Warner ended up dropping the AOL name for good in 2005. Next. So Hulu is actually a recent service, and it's a live streaming service provider. And Time Warner bought 10% stake in this company for $583 million. And the purpose of this was to bring all these like CNN, Cartoon Network, TBS, and the Turner Classic Movies, everything to this Hulu's on-demand and live service, so that it gives like easy access to audiences around the globe. And Time Warner actually hopes that this will be a new platform and that they can build new platforms for delivery of more high content with Hulu. So the most recent merger, and which is in talks with Time Warner, is AT&T. AT&T offered to buy Time Warner last year for $85 billion. And however, the Justice Department of US, they sued to stop the merger because they are afraid that these two companies merging together, they will increase the price and the TV subscribers will end up paying a lot more than, because they'll become a beast in the media conglomerate industry. So, but however, there are advantages to AT&T and Time Warner merger, because AT&T, they're not direct competitors. AT&T actually, they distribute TV and movie content, while Time Warner is the one producing them, like HBO and CNN. And this would actually be a vertical merger for them. There has been a legal battle since the announcement of this merger, and it has been pushed back to June 2019 as for now. Other mergers include acquisitions actually. Time Warner actually bought LA Entertainment. Any of you heard of Gossip Girl, Pretty Little Liars?
Yes.
Are you a fan of these?
No. Yes.
Yeah. Okay, some of you are. They all come under LA Entertainment, and thus Time Warner bought the company. Now they have the rights to publish these books, publish the movies, and all the rights to these movies and these books. Gossip Girl, and they have so far sold tens and millions of copies around the globe. And there's also the recent purchase of Bleacher's Report for $175 million. Bleacher's Report is actually a global destination for sports fans. So they hope that this will create like social channels for millennial sports fans and a sports website where they can air all their sports related items and shows. Okay. I'll be passing on to you.
So we're talking about Time Warner's concentration strategies. So there are vertical integration and horizontal integration, both happens in Time Warner. So what is vertical integration? Vertical integration is when the production company has the ownership of the means of production, distribution, and exhibition of the film by the same company in order to receive more profit. For example, this film is the Harry Potter and the Deathly Hallows Part 2, which is also known as Harry Potter 7. This movie was created by Warner Bros. Pictures in association with Payday Films, and then was distributed by Warner Bros. Distribution. Besides, HBO also ran a behind-the-scenes making of this film, and then Time Magazine also ran special features on it before and after the film was released to make sure the people not only watch this film in the cinema and also buy the DVD sales. So what is horizontal integration? Horizontal integration is the process of a company where a production company expands into other areas of one industry. For example, it's Warner Bros. Studios and Pictures, Rocksteady Games, DC Comics, and New Line Cinema. So DC Comics is owned by Warner Bros. And then they release films which has the DC superheroes applied to their films, such as Batman, Superman, Green Lantern, and so on. They want to gain additional profit other than their generic live action films, and also want to gain wide audience, such as the fan superheroes from the Rocksteady Games. Next. So, Time Warner now has four main strategies. First, they want to use leading skills and brands to create the best content. Time Warner wants to increase investment in production, programming, and marketing from $14.5 billion to $19 billion. Besides, the Turner segment also will double its yearly investment to $1 billion by 2018. Also, Time Warner attempting to deepen the content synergy between its divisions, such as the KISS initiative global process. This thing is to expand its Kids International business due to the collaboration with the Turner's Cartoon Networks and the Bonus Bros DC Comics. The second strategy by Time Warner is expand internationally in faster growing territories. Between 2010 and 2013, Time Warner has gained full control of most of its international HBO partnership and established and extended its control elsewhere. During 2004, 80% of its revenue, which is $42 billion, was produced in the US and Canada. And during 2014, the produce has decreased until 70%. So the third strategy is they want to lead digital transition of media industry. In 2015, they have confronted OTT service such as Netflix directly with HBO Now. Besides, they also investing in new digital delivery service for HBO Go and other TV everywhere service. The fourth strategy of Time Warner is they want to focus on operating and capital efficiency. They has paid out 9.173 billion in dividends and repurchased 42.6 billion in common shares. Besides, 5 billion of shares repurchased following 21st Century Fox acquisition offers.
So in conclusion, Time Warner actually started when Sam and Albert Warner invested only $150 in the company, and today they actually invested this money to show this Life of an American Fireman movie, and today it's worth $85 billion. And it's one of the biggest media conglomerates, and it reached this by a lot of ups and downs, huge losses, experimenting with different fields and taking risks and expanding their business both horizontally and vertically.